I'm Bill Dalrymple from Dalrymple Farms. We're a family-run business for about 45 years. We're currently raising 300 acres of wine grapes. We're located on the east side of Seneca Lake. We grow everything from natives to hybrids to vinifera. In this region of New York State, we have a lot of concern for cold temperatures and sensitive varieties. This past winter, we got down to -3. This Riesling block that we have here showed 25% bud damage on it. If there is damage, then knowing before you trim is very important. That way we can compensate for any loss that we may see so we can still bear out a normal crop, not only for economic reasons, but for health reasons of the vine.
Anyone growing grapes in the Finger Lakes knows that it's a challenge, especially with the cold winter temperatures. Back several years ago, we decided we needed a tool to help growers assess their vines for bud injury. Starting the first of the year, I go out and I take samples from the vineyards all winter long, every other week. Doesn't matter if it's snowing, raining, windy, cold, whatever. While I'm out here, I'm also checking the temperature sensor that we have, and I'm bringing it back to the lab and putting a new one out so that we can record the temperatures every 15 minutes so we know how cold it actually got out here. Quite often we get questions from growers about wind chill and how it relates to a grapevine. When it comes down to it, wind chill means nothing to a grapevine. So I'm out here today walking through the vineyard. I'm taking samples that are representative of what you would leave as fruiting canes for the coming year. We're gonna test the buds for hardiness. So I take them back to the lab after this and drop them off to Bill.
My name is Bill Wilsey. I work for Cornell and the statewide viticulture program. Part of my job is to do cold hardiness tests for the different grape varieties around the Finger Lakes. What we'll do is we'll test the cold hardiness of these different varieties, calculate a lethal temperature, and we will graph them with the high and low temperatures each day. So this is a tool to help the grower out. When the low temperature reaches the lethal temperature, that's when we expect to find bud damage. To begin the test, I cut the buds off of each cane. Once I've collected 30 of the buds, I take this plate. Each plate consists of 9 cells. I put 10 buds in each cell, and there is a thermocouple which records the freezing point of each bud. After we put the buds on here, we take a little foam pad and we cover them up as to insulate them. So I'm going to now put them in the freezer and hook up the electrodes on here so we can take the readings as the temperatures go down. If you remember in your physics class, when water freezes, it gives off a spike of energy or spike of heat. These buds, when they reach their freezing point, will freeze and give off a spike of energy. As you can see, when we graph this data, it kind of looks like a heartbeat. This multimeter will record that energy peak when it occurs. This machine reads every cell every 15 seconds. For the whole run, it records 3,100 lines of data. We can then take this data, put it into a program, and actually go in and actually be able to see these peaks, read the peaks, know exactly what temperature these buds froze at, so then we can take all that peak data and come up with the lethal temperatures for these buds.
This year with Cornell's testing, they showed a large damage in cab francs. That gave us the notion to go check our own, and sure enough, we found that we had significant amount of damage in our cab francs also. So we were able to adjust for that in our trimming practices, and we find it very beneficial to our industry.